With a Synology high-availability cluster, you can perform failover within minutes, rapidly restoring access to your data and significantly reducing the cost of unplanned downtime. In this video, we'll show you how to set up a high-availability cluster using two DS1517 Plus units. A high-availability cluster consists of two identical NAS devices, an active server and a passive server, linked via a heartbeat connection. Access to the cluster is maintained via a cluster connection. While the active server handles all user requests, data is continuously replicated onto the passive server. Should the active server fail, access to your files can be quickly restored via the passive server. To set up a high availability cluster, you must have two identical NAS models. The number and capacity of the drives used on both the active and passive servers must be the same, and the drives must also be located in the same location on each device. Both the active and passive servers must have the same number of LAN ports. If the servers are equipped with additional network interface cards, these network cards will also count as additional LAN ports. Both servers must be assigned static IP addresses and be located within the same subnet. You must also ensure that both servers are running the same version of the Disk Station Manager operating system and the High Availability Manager package. To assign a static IP address to a given server, log into Disk Station Manager, go to Control Panel, Network, Network Interface. Select the interface you wish to use before going to Edit, IPv4, and Use Manual Configuration. To set up a high availability cluster, log into DSM on the NAS device you wish to use as the active server, and download and install High Availability Manager from the Package Center if you have not already done so. Open High Availability Manager and click on Create High Availability Cluster. Select the cluster and heartbeat interfaces to be used. Both the heartbeat connection between the active and passive servers, as well as the cluster connection, must be attached via the same interface on both devices. A direct connection is recommended for the heartbeat connection. However, if using a switch, the network must be isolated, so only the two hosts are on the same subnet. Enter the administrator's username and password for the passive server. Choose a name for the cluster. The cluster host name must be different from that of both the active and passive servers. Choose an IP address for the high availability cluster from the provided range. This is a virtual IP and will be used to access your files once the cluster has been set up, and can be any LAN IP address not currently in use by other services. Do not use the IP address of either the active or passive servers to access your files after the cluster has been set up. After DSM has verified your settings, click Next. If existing volumes or LUNs are detected on the active server, you can choose to either keep or erase them. Deleting existing SCSI LUNs and volumes on the active server will reduce the amount of time needed to set up the cluster. Confirm your settings before clicking Apply to complete the process. To learn more about getting the most out of your Synology NAS, subscribe to the Synology YouTube channel or visit the link in the description.